Hey everyone and welcome back to SkyBlock, and guys, fantastic news! So, I promised you guys I will bring you back in as soon as we do have 3 villagers scattered, and look at my new friends over here. Oh, whoa, almost fell down. So yeah, we did get another librarian here, which does have an awesome glass trait. 5 glass for 1 emerald. Which is cool, and he has a Flame 1 book. We also did get this guy, so yeah. You can get all kinds of wool from him, all colored. And yeah, I was selling him some of my white wool that I gathered up with all the strings that we collected from the mob farm here. So what are we doing with those 3 guys? Now, first I was thinking let's trade even more with them, and yeah, that is a good idea. And I will do that from time to time. But we do want to get even more villager, right? So, yeah. This is where we will lay down the foundation for a villager breeding system. Oh yes, we will totally go there. And let me grab a few items just to get us started. First things first, I think we will build that like over here-ish. Yeah, should be good, should be good. Yeah, so we will get awesome villagers to trade and stuff like that, so I'm looking forward to that. I definitely do. I love my villagers though, so yeah, let's create a little bit of a foundation here. I thought I heard something, sorry. alright. So, how exactly do I want to do this? I am not too sure. Well, obviously they will stand right here. Whoops. This is the spot where they will stand. Oh, I forgot something, sorry. And I want them to stand on a jack-o'-lantern, actually, so yeah, easy lighting there. Let's get one of those crafted up, shall we? There we go. I know it does, yeah, it does look a bit weird, but oh well, come on. It's just for the lighting, and it's just one block in the freaking ground, so yeah, not that bad, right? All right. Okay, so we will need a back wall, obviously. Let's get a little bit of that going, just so we know what we are dealing with here. Okay, so this is where the villagers will stand, so we will need, whoops, not that block there though. We will need a block right here to contain them, and what else? If those guys are breeding, we want the baby villagers to travel to the outside here, where we can send them up a water elevator on both sides, actually. Like this. Okay. So we will have solid blocks over here and over here. And I think just a slab down here will fulfill the purpose. Yeah, it should, right? Perfect. So we will build that one up as well. Like this. So let's just create a little bit of a wind up here. So the villagers will come up here on the side and here on the side. We could move them to the front here and distribute them somewhere over here. Could be a good idea, or behind. That could be, yeah, that could work out pretty well. So what we will need definitely are some signs on the floor here, so we can put water on this level. And actually a sign there, and there, and that's all the signs that I have at the moment, but okay. Ah, oh, do I have my glass? I do. Where do we want the glass? Well, obviously, definitely there, so we can see our guys, and we do need something to give them their food, right? So I was thinking, well, easiest thing to do would be a dispenser. So let's get free. Really? Three strings. One piece of redstone dust. Was that a little one? Yeah, it was. I don't like to keep those guys around. They have to go. Perfect. Perfectamundo. Okay, let's see. Let's see here. What we will need is, first things first, a bow. Good. And then we can go to the redstone stuff. Where are you? I'm always. Oh! Dispenser. There we go. And to control that thing, I think a lever will definitely be enough. Perfect. And we will just incorporate that thing in the back wall, I guess. Yeah, why not? Why not? Yeah. Let's just replace that block. Okay, I hope that those things doesn't shoot out to the side. And for now, let's just do that. Obviously, we will improve on that for sure. But for now, let's leave it like that because we don't actually have a big of a choice there. So yeah. Alrighty. So we would have water here and there. And actually, I think on that spot as well to minimize the randomness. But for the moment, we will leave it like that. And we want to be able to see our villagers traveling up. So definitely glass on the side here. And then we can collect them on top somewhere. Let's just build this one up. Or two? Should we go for two? Not too sure. I know I shouldn't wing this stuff, but yeah, this is a very old design. I can't remember where I saw that the first time. Yeah. Sorry. Okay, so they will come up here. Which is nice, which is good. We will have to push them down in the middle here and then over that way. That should work out pretty well. So let's build that out. And then we can just. Let's drop them over here. Or something like that. Yeah, let's see if that works. It should, basically. In theory. Okay, let's just block that things up. And what else do we have to do? Well, first we will have to get our villagers over from over there to over here. Drop two of them down there. And that's when the fun really starts, right? Because let's just light this place up. Just make sure nothing can spawn here. Would obviously be a bad thing with the villagers, so yeah. Okay. Yeah, I think I will transport them with water, actually. Should be the easiest way, right? Yes. Okay. But for this to work, we will have to add something. And we will need to add this, like. Why did I do that? Come on. Like 6 or 7 blocks above. So. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That should do the trick. Let's just leave that there as an indicator. Okay. Something among these lines should do the trick. We'll need slabs over there. Perfect. Oh, actually, we will need them on top as well. Like that. Like over there, over here, and obviously over here. So that will be the first villager that we will have to drop in. We will have a slab here, so we do have to extend this out one more. And we will put down some doors here. So yeah, that is pretty much the plan. Let me gather up a good amount of cobble, and then we start try to push one of them over here and see how it goes, right? See you soon, guys. Okay, guys, so what you are seeing here is the preparation stage almost finished, or exactly finished, for the top villager here, our most important guy for now. And as you can see, I have built a huge water canal just to get those guys over here. So we will go down here, so standard little water elevator over here to get them on the top there, and from there it's just, yeah, water canal per water canal. Pretty standard. Wow, that was pretty jumpy, right? They shouldn't be able to get out, I think, but we can. Yeah, perfect. And with a little twist here, perfect. Another elevator over here. So yeah, I think it's time to move our... Oh my... Did you see that? Let's close those gaps though, right? That could have been disastrous. Hey you, how are you doing? Now... No, please, just... Really? Just let me behind... Yeah, move forward, come on. Oh my gosh. Villagers, sometimes... A real pain. Okay, let us actually place a block there. Jump up, place a block here. Get that. And place it down here. We will chase this guy and hopefully everything does go to plan, right? So he's, yeah, slowly but steadily taking... Perfect. Didn't fell out of the canal here. I hope I have built this thing okay everywhere. Or else we are in trouble. And we can use the water elevator there, just make it a little bit shorter to get the other two villagers into their destination. Which is awesome. Okay, guy. So far, you are doing your job perfectly. Oh, is this the glass tree guy? Yeah. Okay. Oh, well. He will be the elder villager of our little... Whoops. Please don't fall off here, please. Yes! Whew! I have to be careful to not fall down in the hole, though, because I can't get out there without killing him or something bad like that. Which we don't want to happen, right? Okay, so far, so good. And that's your destination over there. Perfect, let's block the water up. Yeah, he is in his spot. Hopefully I didn't make a stupid mistake down there now that I'm looking at it. Oh shoot, no. I have to sign there. Whew. That got me scared just a little bit. Ow. Are you actually fine with that barrier? I don't think I have to lower it, right? We can still trade with him though, which is good. And yeah, cool stuff. Cool stuff. Now it is time to get these. Wow, sorry, I can't talk. This guy some doors, actually. That was the word I was looking for. Can we make that jump? Nope. Oh well. At least we tried. Okay, so wood. We will need some ladders. And we will need some birch wood because we will use birch doors. Why? Just because. I don't know. Six will do the job, actually. And we will install a little ladder. Little ladder? A little ladder. La, la, la. A little ladder to this guy somewhere. I just don't know where I should do that. Probably here would fit, right? Nope. Ah. You know what? We will just build a temporary one. Yeah, like over here. Not like that, but like that. Just so we can get up to this guy easily. Oh, come Okay. Yeah, it's not easy. It is not. I think I want to go on a bit more of a secure place for this guy, right? Oh, now he's in the way. Can we notch him a little bit back? We can. Yeah, now he is definitely not going anywhere. Oh, imagine if I couldn't remove that slab. That would be awful, wouldn't it? Okay, we are still looking strong here. I love it. Our last chicken for the moment. We will replace it with some baked potatoes. All right, my friend, it is time to give you some doors. Did I? Yeah, I did. I could actually just get rid of those blocks here. Open this door. Get rid of this block. Yeah, that does work. That does work perfectly. And we can put down some torches over here. Nothing should be able to spawn down in this space, I guess. Just make sure everything is lit up well enough. Okay. Whew. Always scares me, but it is the best way to catch a ladder is just to try it. Yeah. Okay. Now we will have to adjust. Ouch. The elevator here to get our friends into this hole, which is the spot where we want them. Let's collect this. And as you can see, I have added this water source there, so the babies will be pushed out to any side if they move a little bit. Which should work out fine. In theory. Okay. Now, we want these guys to drop down here. There. So, yeah, let's just temporarily put some cobblestone in here. Oh, we can actually place a ladder there. Same effect for the water. So, yeah, we are good to go. Should we just go for it? Let's see, that's the side of the elevator. Well, actually, wait a second. If we. Ah. Let's see, how much damage did that cause? A little bit, not too much. Let me see, I want to get to somewhere like there-ish, right? So I can remove this guy and that guy actually. Yeah. Let's get the block in there. Now they would, if they swim up, they would, will they be able to just go around the side like that? Obviously we will have to replace this ladder with a sign, so these guys don't just climb to that ladder, which would be pretty bad. Ooh, let's place a torch here, and yeah, just some on the ground here, so spawn proof, it has to be. Alright, okay, yeah, that should allow us to, this is a little bit, yeah. Yeah, that does allow us to remove the elevator until we hit the level that we need it, so... Oh, you know what? Yeah, why not? Why not just make this easy on us, right? Perfect. Okay, first things first, this water source, not needed anymore. Oh yeah, right, we should protect this guy from lightning. Which we will do with a glass block over his head. And that is all the protection you get, mate, sorry. He should be fine, come on guys. Actually, really, he should be. There's no reason he's not, so yeah. Hey, I mean, he is the... Yeah, the godfather of our civilization that we will have, so yeah, we do have to protect him. He deserves it. Huh. Yeah, I know exactly what I think sometimes. Mm-hmm. Okay, I think we are safe to remove that one as well. Okay. Hey dude. How do you like your new home? Pretty cool, huh? Oh wow, these are full blocks then. Yeah, let's just light this up really good. Okay. There we go, get the sign back. Let's get rid of that water source. Okay. Now I think that's the one we need right there. But let's just block it up for now. We can easily replace that. We do have our bucket of water on the hand, so... Let's continue dismantling this thing. Yeah, you see, sometimes you do have a lot of scaffolding and stuff like that around and temporary builds, but hey, it's actually worth it. It definitely is though. If you're working with villagers, you all went through the trouble of moving them around and stuff, right? So. You can't be too safe with those guys. Okay, we don't need that sign anymore. And just for safety reason, put a torch in there and block this off, actually. Let's go in here. Oh, that's a bit... Yeah, we'll have to put the block there, right? If you're swimming up, you will get pushed over. Yeah, that is good. That's good. Yeah, guys, that is almost everything we need to get the other villagers in here, right? Oh, crap. Okay, you know what? That doesn't look really safe. Okay, let's collect all the stuff that we dropped. Yeah, and get some more lights down while we're at it. Thankfully, we can pick the stuff up. Oh, shoot! I knew I had forgot something, but yeah, we will have to deal with that afterwards. For now, we will just move those guys over to here, I guess. All right. So far, so good. You know what? I will make a little cut. Collect all the stuff that is to collect on my farm, so we can hopefully make some trades. And yeah, sleep so we have day and kill the animals off and stuff like that. So I will be back in a minute. Alrighty, guys, we are ready to send the second guy on its journey. And yeah, let's see how this goes. Did I? Yeah, awesome. Hopefully, he doesn't have the same idea that I just had with getting out there. Please stay in. Oh, you freaking moron! Why do you. Why would you? Why would you? Go back in! That scared me so much. Honestly. If he falls down, then I'm really angry. No! Go down there. Go into the water. Perfect. Wow. Wow. That was scary. That was really scary. Oh my God. Thankfully, nothing happened to our precious villager. Wow. That would have sucked if I had to farm for another one. Oh my days. Come on, dude. Do us a favor. I don't want to speed up this bit. I just want to show you this one guy make it into the second cell, or the breeding cell actually, and not the detector villager village stuff thing up there. Don't look at me, dude. If you're too close, they'll try to interact with you and stuff like that, so they're fighting the currency. Which is not good. Yeah, just travel down there. Slowly and steady. Hopefully, I didn't mess that elevator up too much, though. We will see in just a bit. What was that? Yeah, I know. I know, it's a bit of a pain. But you can make it. Come on. Yeah, good boy. He's going up and he's going over, but he gets a little bit stuck here, which isn't that bad because we can always get in and do a little helping hand. Can we push you? Wow, sometimes I can't really believe the luck that I have. Can we? Yes, we can. Okay. Let's place a ladder down. Get out of this place. Destroy the ladder actually as well. And get rid of this block. So he is down there. Perfect. I will move the second villager here as well and we meet up as soon as he arrives. Okay, guys, it is done. Look at that. Perfect, right? We do have our two villagers in there, like we wanted to, which is awesome. And those two glass blocks. They will go in here, actually. If he will. If he's willing to place. Come on, move a little bit. Just a little bit to the side so I can place this. Please! No. Oh, come on. Don't be that guy. Really? But yeah, we do have to take some security stuff now. We have to make sure that nothing can drop down there. And for now, what we will do is just place some cobblestone down. I know, it doesn't look that good and stuff, but hey, it just has to be safe for now. And yeah, so I will have to dismantle all this stuff here. And I will have to farm some potatoes or carrots, I think carrots. And then we can take a look if this actually works. Okay, guys, do you see that? Yes, we do have our first baby. That's true. It's not only food that triggers them to breed, it's also if you trade with them. And due to the fact that I have traded with both of these guys, yeah, we just received a baby one. And this is a cleric which will buy our rotten flesh, so we will keep this little fellow definitely on our hand. Now, I'm thinking of moving those guys actually. Not the breeder itself, that will stay there, but the villagers that we do want to trade with. And now, watch out. I'm fi Whoa. You're not hostile at the moment, which is good. Yeah, but I was thinking to like move them over to here-ish or something, build like a little holding area for them, or I don't know, that's a bit of a far distance though, right? So maybe we can think about a second story. Yeah, it would be more like a basement stuff, so yeah, could work out. I'm not too sure, but as you can see, first baby villager is in. Pretty cool. I went ahead and yeah, went for two stacks of carrots. So as soon as they stop, wow, as soon as they will stop breeding, I will give them some food and we should be good. So yeah, next thing for me is to tear down the whole water canal system over here and this temporary bridge, and yeah, really get this stuff back into its natural state, right? And I will do this off camera until next episode it is done, I guess. And yeah, but for now I will have to say goodbye because yeah, we are almost out of time again. So yeah, let's see if we can get our little baby in the view. We can. So yeah, thanks you. Thank you. Wow, dude. Okay, guys, thank you very much for watching. Leave a like on the episode if you enjoyed it. And yeah, as always, guys, take care. Bye bye.